Welcome to Wake Up America. Most Americans agree that tax reform should be one of this nation's biggest priorities. Our present tax system has simply become obsolete. It's riddled with loopholes and provisions that are largely unfair to the average citizen, and it is in dire need of an overhaul. America needs reform that will address the bevy of problems that have plagued the current tax system for so long. To most of Washington, reform simply means new ways to tax the American people. But there is a better way, a smarter way to raise revenue. A way that Republicans can support without violating their pledge to Grover Norquist. A way Democrats can support without taxing the poor into bankruptcy. A way that would strengthen the middle class rather than draining it of its life's blood. Most importantly, a way that will make America competitive and prosperous on the world stage once again. It's called the Competitive Tax Plan, and it's a pragmatic 21st century approach to our troubled modern economy. Unthinkable as it may be, this plan could allow 125 million Americans to pay their taxes without ever having to deal with the IRS again. How is this possible? Essentially, the Competitive Tax Plan would eliminate the income tax on the first $50,000 earned by single payers and $100,000 earned for couples. This means that if a couple filing jointly earned $100,000 and $1 in a year, they would pay taxes on only $1. Deductions would still exist for things like children, mortgage, student loan payments, and even charitable contributions. But most other deductions may be eliminated altogether, thus closing loopholes and simplifying the tax filing process. For the average American, this is a very small price for paying no taxes at all in their first $100,000 earned. So this puts more money in the pockets of hardworking Americans, and it also means less taxes on their savings and investments, which translates to even more stability. Obviously, Uncle Sam will need to make up this lost income somewhere. So the competitive tax plan also means adding a border consumption tax. This is where the United States has fallen behind the rest of the world economically. For example, China currently earns 20% of its national income from import taxes. When something from the U.S. is shipped to China, they hit it with border adjustable taxes. This results in those American-made goods being more expensive and thus less desirable to Chinese consumers. U.S. companies annually pay an accumulative average of more than $550 billion to China and other nations around the world from one type of border adjustable sales tax alone, the value-added tax. In contrast, today's United States earns less than 1% from border adjustable taxes. This means that American money is being used to not only keep our own government afloat, but also pay import taxes that sustain the governments of countries like China. This lopsided relationship is evaporating taxpayer money. By taxing the imports shipped to our shores from all over the world, it is more than just the working Americans that would carry a lighter load. It would also be possible to drop the corporate tax from 35 to 15%. We could also rebate our new national consumption tax to American exporters, just as every other nation currently does. By increasing the advantages of producing, saving, and investing in the U.S., we could finally start to bring jobs back home to American workers. This would stimulate economic growth and lower unemployment in the United States. Above all, the competitive tax plan would allow us to be globally competitive. It would put the cost of doing business in the United States on an equal playing field with the rest of the world. Our politicians have been talking about tax reform for decades, but every plan seems to be simply another way to tax the same people again, hardworking, middle-class Americans. It's time for this nation to become competitive once again. It's time to get back on the road towards a stronger economy and nation. The competitive tax plan is a plan all Americans can get behind, and it's time we let Washington know that we're ready.
For more news and information, please log on to economyincrisis.org.